boys and girls and families. It's so good to see you. My name is Miss Laura and I am the Director of Family Ministry and Christian Education at Grace United Methodist Church in Gaithersburg. I'm so glad that we can be here together. I'm here in my cozy space. This is going to be our engage room and I'm trying to get it all ready. We're going to paint the walls and everything so it's going to be nice and snuggly for all of our engage moments. So, welcome to my cuddly little nook. This is where we're going to have our lessons and I hope you're all dressed in comfy clothes like I suggested because I've got my comfy clothes on. See? We are going to be doing some exercises today. So, let me get my handy dandy book. Okay. The study we are doing is called Managing Our Emotions. So we have covered many emotions so far. And in the last lesson we did, which was on Tuesday, we covered fear and frustration. Now, let's get comfy, boys and girls. Snuggle in. And if you haven't got your pajamas on, I suggest you run and get them and put your pajamas on so you can be nice and cozy. Okay, so last lesson, the fear and frustration, I really want to go over this again with you. We learned that we are created by God with emotions. We all have emotions. We explored biblical examples of emotions expressed in the Bible. Hi, Crumpet. So that means that we read some Bible stories where the disciples, Jesus, just people in the Bible were showing emotions. And I'm going to tell you that story again in a minute. Do you know what else we did? We discovered the top 10 things that children find scary or annoying. Write in the comments, boys and girls, if you know what that might be. See, let's see if you can get any in the top 10. If you missed our lesson on Tuesday, let's see if you can get in the top 10 of scary things that children find scary and annoying. We are also today, hence the comfy area, we are going to be doing some exercises to help you when you are anxious. So they include deep breathing, straw breathing, and something called emotional freedom technique, EFT, but it's also known as tapping. That's a lot easier than saying emotional freedom technique, right? So we are going to be, I'm going to be teaching you tapping, which can help when you are feeling anxious. Right, so let's talk about the Bible story from last week. The Bible story we did, I'm going to have to turn my fan on, it's getting hot in this little nook here. The Bible story we did was from the book of Mark. And it was about, because I told you we looked in the Bible to find where people showed emotions, and in this particular story it was the disciples that showed their emotion of fear. So my book's falling apart. I think I need to do a craft project and tape my book back together. So in the Bible story in Mark, I'm going to read it to you again, just in case you missed it on Tuesday. Okay, have you got your listening ears on, boys and girls? See if you can pick out the part where emotions, like feelings, are talked about. Feelings could be, fear or happiness, excitement, being anxious, being sad, being worried. There's lots of emotions. See if you can pick some out here in this story. It's called Fear in the Dark. It was evening and Jesus said to his disciples, "Let's go to the other side, guys." They got into one of the empty boats. There were other boats too. A huge storm storm came up and there was lots of wind and big waves. Their boat had water splashing into it. The disciples thought it would sink. The disciples were afraid, but Jesus was fast asleep, his head on a cushion. The disciples woke him up and exclaimed, "Don't you care that we might die in this storm?" Jesus stood up and said, "Peace, be still." And the storm stopped. It was calm. Then he turned, we're talking about Jesus, then he turned and questioned his disciples, "What are you afraid of? Have you no faith?" The disciples were really surprised that Jesus had power over the storm. So, which emotions did you see in this story? I'd love you to put in the comments which emotions that you saw in that story from the disciples. In fact, I think we might do a quick craft project before we go into our breathing exercises. So, let's see. I happen to have a handy dandy bucket here beside me. What do I have? I have paper in my handy dandy bucket. What color do you think I should use, boys and girls? How about, this one's a light purple. Purple's my favorite color, so let's use this one. And I have some scissors. Now you can do this later. I obviously don't expect you all to have this on hand right now. I have some new markers that I've never used before, so I might try and use a couple of those. We'll see how that goes. And then I've got a stapler. And just in case that doesn't work, which often happens, I have some glue. So let's do this craft project, and it doesn't take very long at all, and it's a fun thing to do. Have you been doing lots of crafts at home, boys and girls? With being stuck at home for such a long time with no school or sometimes not being able to see our friends, there's lots of opportunities to do arts and crafts, right? Okay, I am going to cut out a kind of circle. Now, this doesn't have to be perfect. You are already perfect in God's eyes. You do not need your craft projects to be perfect also. So when I cut this out, I had both pieces of paper together so that they came out the same size. Now, this is where the fun begins. Let's draw our picture. So if I'm drawing a picture from the Bible story that I just told you, what would I draw? Now, if you watched our lesson on Tuesday, you would see that I drew a boat, and I think I'll probably do the same thing. And I drew some stick figures in the boat. So let's do that again. I'm gonna try some upside down drawing. All right, let's see how this upside down boat turns out. All right, there we go. There's the bottom of the boat. Can you see? I'll hold it closer to you after I've finished. I've put a sail on. I don't know if it was a sailboat or not, but I put a sail on anyway, just in case the disciples wanted to sail away. All right, let's do some disciples. We'll do stick figure disciples. How many should we do? Let's do three disciples. And let's do Jesus. Now, what was Jesus doing in that boat? He was sleeping. It said in the story in the Bible, Jesus was sleeping with his head on a cushion, fast asleep during the big storm, because he wasn't afraid. So let's do Jesus right here, looking really comfy, laying on a cushion. All right, let's find, where did I put my colors? Right here. These are new, these are called acrylic paint markers. Let's pull out a red and see how this goes. I think you have to shake it. Have you used these before, boys and girls? I haven't. Okay. Let's color in a sail. Ooh, these are nice. I like these markers. There we go. Colour in a sail, and let's colour in part of the boat. There we go. Now, what about the storm? I don't really know how to draw a storm, so we'll do some squiggles. Here we go. The squiggles are the storm. And Jesus was sleeping. And his disciples said, "Why were you sleeping? There's a huge storm." And Jesus told them off because they were afraid and they didn't trust God to keep them safe. So you can draw anything from the parable that I read, from the story that I read, excuse me. So it could be a boat, the disciples, any part of it. And then on the back, I'd like you to write down where it was in the Bible. Now, it's in the book of Mark. Where are we? It was in the book of Mark, chapter 4, verse 35. So let's write on the back here. Mark. Here we go. Mark, chapter 4, verse 35. Here we go. So I've got my scripture on the back, and I have my drawing on the front. Now, this is a paint stick, and you can get this at any of the Home Depot or places like that. And if you can't find a paint stick, you don't need to worry too much. You can use something else. I'm sure you can be creative and find something else. Maybe the middle of a paper towel or something like that. Now, to stuff this, you could use some paper towels, some tissue paper, and the book advises that you put this in the middle so it'll be nice and poofy when you staple it together. So let's see if I can make this work. All right, stapler, let's do it. It would help if I could open the stapler. So when you do these craft projects, boys and girls, I would love to see them. I would love for you to post them. Okay, so you know what you could do with this when it's done? You could use it as a fan. You could fan yourself with it. All right, let's see how this turns out. Come on, stapler. Oh, almost. This is why I bought backup glue, boys and girls, just in case. All right. So let's just imagine that I stapled this together on my stick. I'm gonna have to glue it because my staple is not working. So I have this on this side. I have my picture from the parable. And on the back, I have the Bible verse so that when I fan myself, I know just where to turn in the Bible. Now let me come down and show you. Oh, sorry, Crumpet. There we go. There's the Mark, that's the chapter. Can you see here? See my drawing? I bet you could do a better job than that. And then we put our paint stick in the middle. And we could use it as a fan, which you need on hot days like this. Okay. Let's move on and get into our breathing techniques. So, because we were talking about fear and frustration, we talked about ways that you could calm down. If you are feeling fearful, frustrated, a lot of anxiety, being worried, the things that I am about to teach you can help with that. Because when you feel like that, you sometimes feel like it's going to last forever, that you feel really, really bad, and you just want to be able to feel calm and happy. And it's helpful to learn these techniques that can teach you to calm down instead of having all this anxiety. So the first one is deep breathing. So we are going to breathe in through your nose and then out through your mouth. So, I'm reading the wrong one. All right, so get comfy, boys and girls. Get nice and comfy. I'm comfy on my cushions. Try and sit up straight though, so you can fill your lungs with all the air. Okay, you ready, boys and girls? Try and relax your body. Sit up straight, but relax your body. And if you can, close your eyes. If you're comfortable doing that, close your eyes. You are going to breathe in through your nose as long and hard as you can. And then you are going to breathe out with your mouth. Now, I am going to make noise when I'm breathing out. You don't have to do that, but I just want you to be able to hear when I am doing this. So this is great for when you're feeling worried or frustrated, or this is a great technique. So boys and girls, big breath in through your nose. And out from your mouth. So you go in through your nose and it fills your body up. Do you feel it filling your body up? And when you blow out through your mouth, let your body relax, kind of like a balloon. Like you're filling it up and then you're letting the air out. So let's do that again, boys and girls. Breathe in through your nose. And out through your mouth. Let's do two more. Ready? Good job, boys and girls. Did that feel good? Did that feel kind of relaxing? That kind of breathing helps you to relax your body, especially if you're all tense and your body's tight. That can really help with that. Now, there is another one. Let me see if I can find my thing. There we go. Handy dandy straw. So you can use a metal straw if that's all you've got in your house, or paper straw, but this is called straw breathing. Now, just like we did, we're going to breathe in hard through our nose, I mean nice and deep through our nose, but when we exhale, when we breathe out, we're going to do that using a straw. This helps you control your breathing. And you know what, this, a lot of therapists or counselors use this technique, so it's used all across the world. So, you know, don't feel silly doing this, boys and girls, if it helps you to relax. So you're going to breathe in nice and deep and breathe out through the straw. So ready? Breathe in. Okay, so you've got to breathe in. You can just pretend you've got a straw, because I don't expect you to have one by your side right now. But breathe in nice and deep, and then breathe out through the straw, and that controls your breathing. Okay, let's do it one more time, nice and deep. There we go. I would like you to practice that, boys and girls. I would like you to practice that every evening, even if you're not feeling anxious. It just makes the body feel good and helps you calm down and kind of get into a restful state. So I would encourage you trying this. Okay, the next thing we have is very interesting. It is called tapping. So I'm going to come a little bit closer and read this to you. Now this, excuse me, doggy, excuse me. Thank you. This tapping, I have to tell the truth, I'd never heard of this before. I'd never heard of such a thing, but apparently it is used all across the world. And there are classes that teach it, and apparently it's a technique that lots and lots of people use and say it helps to calm them down. And it can help with lots of different things. So I'm going to read it to you. Instead of babbling on, let me read to you what it says in this book, which is The Managing Your Emotions, written by the United Methodist Women. Okay, so it is called tapping, like I said. Imagine your bodies as filled with wires. These wires can be called nerves. These wires run from one part of the body to another, connecting them. Let me turn my fan off. I want to make sure that you can hear me. So for instance, the brain and the heart are connected by a wire inside your body. then the wires are nerves. So inside your body, your brain and your heart are connected by a wire. It's called a nerve. The toes are connected to the knees
with a wire,
a nerve.
The eyes are
connected to the brain with a nerve, just like the ears.
All these
parts of the body connect together to make the parts of our body work well together, just as God had planned it. So this is how it works, and I don't want to lose you by reading too much, but I really want you to know how this works before we proceed and do it ourselves. And I plan on doing this quite often, boys and girls, because I practiced it before, you know, I came in obviously to teach you this evening, and it really does work. It really does help. Helps the aches and pains. So
each wire.
Now, what are the wires, boys and girls? Your nerves. So each wire has a little bud at the end.
These buds are called
the nerve endings, and this is where the nerve is most sensitive. In pushing these buds, the nerve reacts with pain or tingling or a push sensation that is felt all the way along the length of the nerve to another place in the body. Now, when this nerve is touched, it is stimulated to be more alert, healthier, function better, calm down or rev up. The place where the nerve goes to is also stimulated to be more alert, healthier, function better, calm down or rev up. Now, there are certain areas of the body that are most important buds or nerve endings because they go to the most important places of the body that keep us healthy, such as the heart and the brain.
Now, often
these nerves cross the body from one side to the other. The most important ones are found in the head and the area around the heart. It's God's amazing plan for the body, and God made the body ready to receive stimulation. I know that's a long word, but you will get to understand it. From these nerves to make the body function well. Now, tapping, that's what it's called, that's what we're about to do. Tapping touches these most important nerves. Remember, they're in the brain and around the heart.
Let me say that again, boys and girls.
I'm getting my tongue tangled. So the tapping touches some of the other most important nerves in the face and the chest. So those are very important too. And that is what tapping can help. Now, the brain and various parts of the body are stimulated by frequent tapping, along with an idea that one repeats a positive thought while tapping the area of the body. Positive thoughts, boys and girls. Now, the tapping could be, and we're going to
do this, we're going to say this when we're
doing the tapping. My body is amazing.
I am
calm. I love myself. I am peaceful. I am happy. I am safe. So we can say these things as we're doing the tapping.
Now, remember,
boys and girls, that these videos go onto YouTube as well as the church website and the Engaged Children's Ministry website. So you can watch them as much as you want, or pause and rewind so that you can see how to do this. So don't worry if you're not picking it all up right now. This is something you can go back and watch and learn how to do. The nerves respond to this attention, sending messages to our organs that make the body function well. Anxiety often lessens and fear is quieted as a result of the tapping on these
points. Now, I am going to
show you a page. It's a drawing, like a copy of kind of like cartoons doing some tapping, and I'm going to put this onto the Engage Children's Ministry in the comments so that you can have access to this, because some people are more visual rather than just listening to me blab on too much. So the EFT, the tapping, it uses different acupressure points, so places that we're going to put pressure on, and we're going to practice the tapping, and we're going to do 8 points, which are in the poster that I'm going to show you. And you can print out a copy of this poster and put it on your wall so that when you have some spare time in your bedroom, you'll see it and say, okay, let's do this now, so I can be in a calm state and it can help my body. And it can help maybe if you have some pain, like if you've got a sore knee or something like that, the tapping can help because you are tapping the nerves, which we said are the wires in the body.
All right, so
there's other ones that you can do. You know, I said you could say, I am calm, my body is amazing. You can also help with your fears, because we talked about fears before, boys and girls, in the last lesson. And you could do, you know, one tap, even though I'm afraid of the dark, I am still okay. It is just the dark. I can pray to Jesus in the dark. I can hold my stuffed animal in the dark. I can listen to music in the dark. I am okay. I do not have to be so afraid of the dark.
Now, see, you can say some of these things, these kind of affirmations that can really help you as you're doing these tap-ins. Now, I'm going to show you the drawings, and then we will go ahead and do the tapping ourselves.
Now, as I said, this is going to be on the Engaged Children's Ministry Facebook page, and you can make a copy. It doesn't matter how old or young you are. This is something that you can do. It's not just for children. In fact, when I was researching this, there's lots and lots of grown-up adult classes that do this. There we are. Can you see that? Can you see what they're doing? It shows you directly where to do the tapping. So I will show you how to do it, and then I'll make sure that this poster gets onto the Engaged Children's Ministry Facebook page. Goodness me, this is awkward. I've got a very big dog under my feet. It looks like my dog does not have to do any relaxation techniques because my dog is snoring beneath my feet. All right, I think we need to do some relaxation techniques. I know that this is going to help me. So, get comfy, boys and girls. Squish yourself with cushions. I'm surrounded by nice fluffy cushions. Squish yourself with cushions. Wear your comfy clothes and get ready for tapping.
Okay. Before we start, we're going to do a
nice deep breath, and I've already shown you how we do that. Remember, we breathe in through our nose and out through our mouth. We're going to do one big one, and then I will show you the tapping. Ready, boys and girls?
And that kind of prepares your body
to be doing this. Okay. Now, the first one we're going to do,
inside the edge of your
eyebrow. So find your eyebrows, and in just at the kind of like at the beginning, kind of in the middle of your forehead, but off to the side, right near where your eyebrow starts. That's where one of the buds, like the wires and the nerve, one of the buds is going to be right here. So we're going to do some tapping there.
Now let's go
with the ones that we spoke to before. We already said the dark one. Let's do
okay, let's do my
body is amazing. You ready?
Good. Two fingers, and you're gonna tap, 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 tap. My
body is
amazing. Tap, tap, tap. Good job, boys and girls. Now, you might feel
silly doing this, and you might think, well, that's not going to work, that's not going to do anything. But it's been proven that it does, because you are tapping, as I said, on the nerve endings, and this could really help to calm them down. So don't feel silly doing this, boys and girls. And if you don't want to do it in front of anybody, that's fine. You can do this anywhere. Okay. The side of your head on the outside, close to the outside edge of each eye. So we are going to...
Right here. I
feel
calm. Right here, on the out, right here.
Kind of feel where your cheekbone is.
Just down from the corner of your eye.
Just here.
I feel calm. Good job, boys and girls. So the next one, we are going to go down a little bit
onto your cheekbone. So we're going to kind of go down a little bit right here. Can you feel your cheekbone? We were up here. Now we're going to go down a little bit to just here on your cheekbone.
See, just here. Okay. I can do brilliant things. Good job, boys and girls. Make sure you're tapping that area
with the cheekbone
right here. Tap, tap, tap. It's like you're tapping the nerve saying, calm down. Good job. All right, the next one
is under your nose and above your top lip. So this area right here, above the top lip and beneath
the nose. So right here.
Where you'd have a moustache. So right here, you're going to tap right there, okay?
I know
that God loves me.
Tap, tap, tap. Can you feel anything, boys and girls?
I would never have thought that that would be an area that would be sensitive enough to be able to tap and help the whole nerve that goes to my brain. I would never have known that until we did this. So this is wonderful.
Okay.
Now, under your bottom lip, in the middle of your chin. Now, under your lip, chin,
lip, you've got a little crease right here.
Right underneath. And that's the area that we are aiming for.
Right here.
Trying to do this and talking, not quite working out, so I'll go a little bit lower. I can pray every day.
So in the crease right here. Tap, tap, tap. Good job, boys and girls. Okay, now the next one.
We're going down to our chest. Now, under our collarbone, so feel here, boys and girls. Can you feel that bone along here, going along your chest?
Now, you're
going to want to go in the middle of that collarbone. So you feel
along where that bone is,
and you're going to go right here in the middle of it. So trace it down, and in the middle right there, I'm going to move my necklace out of the way, and that is where we're going to tap.
Ready? I have
lots of people
that love me for who I am. That feels nice.
I can feel that definitely doing something, boys and girls.
These are sensitive areas
because that's where the buds, the end of the nerves are. So all this is sending messages to the brain to be calm. Hopefully none of you have fallen asleep yet.
Tap, tap. Good job.
Good job. Okay, now we are going underneath our arm, in your armpit. Hopefully you've taken a shower today, boys and girls. All right, so just in your armpit, in the general area, little bit down, and we're going to go here.
Are you ready? I am enough. Good job. You might have to do it a little bit harder right there under your armpit. Good job. And the last one, near the bottom of your rib cage on both sides of your chest. So just here. Just here.
I want you to tap.
God made me with emotions, and God loves me for who I am. Good job, boys and girls. That's it.
You did tapping. Now, I want you to print this out and put this on your wall, because even though, as I said, you might feel a little bit silly tapping around to your body, but it does work. It feels good. And it sends messages to your brain, and your brain is an amazing thing. So that's it, boys and girls. If you've got any questions for me, please do contact me. You can email me, or you can go to the Engage Children's Ministry Facebook page and find me, or the Grace Church website, www.graceumc.org. Now, boys and girls, I am going to play the same video on Tuesday. So if you're watching this video on Tuesday, hello from last Thursday. Does that make sense, boys and girls? Is that a bit like Back to the Future? I'm not sure. But I'm going to play this again on Tuesday, just in case somebody missed it and they're not quite sure that they can get the video on YouTube, the Grace Church Facebook page, or the Engage Children's Ministry page. Now, boys and girls, let's close this session with a prayer. I hope that you have learnt some ways to relax. We did the deep breathing, we did the breathing with the straw, and we did the tapping. Now, further on, we can talk about other things, but that, I think, is enough for today. I've really enjoyed spending this time with you. So has Crumpet. Right, Crumpet? No, he's still snoring. Maybe I'll do some tapping on Crumpet. Okay, boys and girls. Let's go into prayer, and then we will finish up tonight's session. Now, put your hands together, close your eyes, and get into
the feeling of prayer. Dear Lord, thank you so much for being with us this evening and sending your Holy Spirit to blanket each and every one of us as we learn how to relax, not be so anxious and not be so worried. And just as you said in your Bible, in your Bible story that we read in the book of Mark, why are we afraid when we know that God has our back? God is looking after us. So please help us to relax and help us to know every day that God is there. God is looking after us. He's out for us, and we don't need a telephone to call him. We can go into prayer and talk to God any time we want. Jesus, thank you for everything you have blessed us with, and we pray all this in your name. Amen. Okay, my lovely, lovely boys and girls, that is enough for today's session. Tuesday, as I said, will be the same. I'm going to play the same one again in case anybody missed it. Look out for the poster in the comments on the Engaged Children's Ministry Facebook page. Now, the next session that we will be going into on the Thursday is titled Finding Power, Helping Others. Finding Power, Helping Others. So that sounds like one you don't want to miss. That will be next Thursday. And this session will be played again on Tuesday. Okay, boys and girls, I love each and every one of you. Each of you. Each and every one of you. Check in on Tuesday. Make sure you check in to Pastor Jim's sermon on Sunday. And look at all the classes, all the Sunday school classes, and all the opportunities we have coming up. All right, boys and girls, cheers and good night.